The topic is topic is nomenclature of the assets. Now in this topic we will learn about how the name of the various asset acid and their anion is given. So first is, what are assets? So student, please write. Acids are those substances. Which furnishes H plus ion. Acids are those substances which furnishes H plus ion. H plus ion is also referred as proton. Number of H plus ion furnished by one molecule of acid is called as its protocity or basicity. So acids are the substance which furnishes H plus ion. H plus ion is nothing but proton. And number of H plus ion furnished by one molecule of the acid is called as its protocity or basicity. It's called as next lihe classification. डार्क करो, इसे हल्का चल रहा है. कपड़ा गीला बहुत है. चलो चलो, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एसिड्स. नेक्स्ट वी हैव क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एसिड. जस्ट सी, एसिड्स आर ऑफ टू टाइप. फर्स्ट इज रेफर्ड एज हाइड्रो एसिड. Second is referred as oxy acid. and third is referred as thioacid. So basically three types of acid: hydroacid, oxyacid, and last is thioacid. This is the classification of acid. Now hydroacid is the acid which has hydrogen plus generally non-metal. Hydrogen plus generally non-metal, these are referred as hydroacid. Oxyacids are having hydrogen, generally non-metal, plus oxygen. So these oxyacid has three types of atom: hydrogen, non-metal, and oxygen. Hydroacid has hydrogen and generally non-metal. Oxyacid has hydrogen, generally non-metal, and oxygen. And thioacids are oxyacid in which oxygen is replaced by sulfur. We obtain thioacid. When oxygen atom of the oxyacid is replaced by sulfur, it is referred as thioacid. So three types of acid: hydroacid, oxyacid, and thioacid. Okay. Now, for example, HCl is hydroacid. H2S is hydroacid. HI is hydroacid. HF is hydroacid. Okay. Oxyacid like H2SO4. Now it has hydrogen, sulfur, and oxygen. It is oxyacid. HNO3, nitric acid, is oxyacid. Chloric acid is oxyacid. So oxyacid has three types of atom: hydrogen, generally non-metal, and oxygen. Like H2SO4, HNO3, and HClO3. Oxyacid are obtained by oxygen replacement with sulfur. Like if you replace one oxygen in this by sulfur, we'll get H2S2O3. If you'll replace one oxygen in this, like this, or if you replace one oxygen in this, so these are example of thioacids. Okay. Next, okay. Next we have again hydroacid. Now we want to name the hydroacids. how naming of hydroacid is given. Now there are two possibilities. Hydroacid is in gas phase, or hydroacid in liquid phase. Okay. Now if it is in gas phase, we'll write it as hydrogen plus non-metal plus iodide. Hydrogen plus non-metal plus iodide. In liquid phase, we write it name as hydro non-metal plus acetic acid. This is the format used for naming hydroacids. For naming hydroacids. Okay. Now let we have HF in gas phase. So we'll call it as hydrogen fluoride. Fluoride. We'll call it as hydrogen fluoride. If HF is in liquid phase, we call it as hydrofluoric acid. We'll call it as hydrofluoric. So this is the format used for naming hydroacid. Similarly, H2S. H2S. If it is in gas phase, it is referred as hydrosulfuric acid. Hydrosulfuric acid. If it is in liquid phase, hydrosulfuric acid. If it is in gas phase, it is referred as hydrogen sulfide. Now in gas phase, it is referred as hydrogen sulfide. And in liquid phase, it is referred as hydro sulfuric acid. So this is the format used for naming hydroacids. Now in case of oxyacid, Hello.
Hello.
जी सर, कुछ प्रॉब्लम होगी क्या आपके एंड पे?
हेलो,
आपको आवाज सुनाई दे रही है सर? हेलो,
आप बस लॉगिन करना पड़ेगा इन लोगों को। हेलो हेलो अपन देख सकते थे इनको, लेकिन ये अपन को नहीं देख पा रहे हैं। कनेक्शन कट गया था, कनेक्शन कट गया था।
दूसरी क्लास स्टार्ट कर देना लोग, क्या इसमें जरूरी है यहाँ से क्लास डिलीवर करना?
तो नहीं नहीं अपना नहीं है, उन्हीं का है, उनके आईटी की गलती है।
दूसरे काम है, 5 बजे देखो। उनका चंदन सर का नंबर क्या है?
चंदन सर का सर उनका तो पता नहीं है। जी सर स्टार्ट हो गए। हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हाँ जी सर, क्या प्रॉब्लम हो गई थी सर? क्या प्रॉब्लम हो गई थी? आप डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए थे। जी सर जी सर अभी करते हैं, एक सेकेंड। हेलो आर यू गेटिंग मी डियर स्टूडेंट? डियर स्टूडेंट आर यू गेटिंग मी? ओके नाउ वी हैव ऑक्सी एसिड्स। आई विल लर्न हाउ टू नेम ऑक्सी एसिड्स। सो एज यूजुअल आई हैव इन्फॉर्म्ड यू कि ऑक्सी एसिड्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ हाइड्रोजन, जनरली नॉन मेटल एंड ऑक्सीजन। जनरली नॉन मेटल एंड ऑक्सीजन, ओके। नाउ वी डिफाइन इट एज, फर्स्ट वी हैव नॉर्मल ऑक्सी एसिड। फर्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन नॉर्मल ऑक्सी एसिड, सेकेंड इज ऑर्थो ऑक्सी एसिड, नेक्स्ट इज पायरो ऑक्सी एसिड एंड मेटा ऑक्सी एसिड. दिस इज अगेन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड, नॉर्मल ऑक्सी एसिड्स, ऑर्थो ऑक्सी एसिड्स, पायरो ऑक्सी एसिड्स एंड मेटा ऑक्सी एसिड्स. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट वी हैव अ नॉर्मल ऑक्सी एसिड. नाउ नॉर्मल ऑक्सी एसिड्स आर फर्दर क्लासिफाइड एज, वन इज रेफर्ड एज रेफरेंस एसिड, ऑन मूविंग टॉप ऑक्सीजन एटम डिक्रीजेस वन बाय वन, एटम डिक्रीजेस वन बाय वन. सो वी हैव वन ऑक्सीजन इज वी हैव रेफर्ड इट एज अस एसिड. एंड वन ऑक्सीजन फर्दर लेस वी रेफर इट एज हाइपो अस एसिड नाउ नेक्स्ट ऑक्सीजन इंक्रीजेस नाउ इट इज रेफर्ड एज पर इक एसिड and this is further referred as hyper peak acid. So this is the classification of normal oxy acid. Oxy acids we have reference acid and oxy acid having one oxygen less is referred as us acid. And oxy acid having one oxygen further less is referred as hypoacid acid. Whereas oxy acid having one oxygen more than the reference acid, it is referred as peric acid. Whereas the oxy acid having one further more oxygen is referred as hyperic acid. So this is the classification of normal oxy acid. Now just see it. We name it as non-metal plus ic acid. This is the format used. Non-metal plus ic acid is the format used. We name it as a non-metal plus us acid. We name this as hypo non-metal plus us acid. Further, we name it as per non-metal plus ic acid. And we name it as hyper non-metal plus ic acid. This is the format used for naming normal oxy acid. Out of normal oxy acid we have reference acid, one oxygen less is referred as us acid, one oxygen further less than reference is referred as hypoacid acid, one oxygen more is referred as peric acid, and one oxygen furthermore is known as hyperic acid. Hyperic acid. Now their name format is non-metal plus ic acid, non-metal plus us acid, hypo non-metal plus us acid. This is per non-metal plus ic acid, hyper non-metal plus ic acid. So this is the format used. Okay, student. Now ortho acids. Just come to ortho acids. Ortho acids are the acids from which one molecule of water can be removed, and resulting molecule is again acid. Now we have ortho acid. Removing one water molecule, it will give us meta acid, a new molecule which is further acting as acid. We call it as meta acid. Okay, now we have pyro acid. It is a dimerization phenomena obtained acid. Two types of acid, removing one H2O and one molecule further, is referred as pyro acid. So we have this classification. First we have classified hydro acid, second we have classified oxy acid, and third we have classified hydro acid, and this is further classification of oxy acid. Okay, students, next just see it, how to use it. That's it. For example, H3PO4. H3PO4 is reference acid. So how do you name the reference acid? Non-metal plus ic acid. Ic acid. So we'll call it as phosphoric acid. Okay. Now one oxygen less, H3PO3. We'll call this as non-metal plus us acid. So non-metal is phosphorus, so we refer it as phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid. Next, just see one more oxygenless, H3PO2. So this acid is referred as hypophosphorus acid. Now we have acid one oxygen more. It is referred as per phosphoric acid. Now H3PO5. We refer as hyperphosphoric acid. Okay, students. Now, by knowing one molecule that reference is phosphoric acid, we can establish further acids like phosphorus acid, like hypophosphorus acid, like perphosphoric acid, like hyperphosphoric acid. Okay?
Now we have list of some reference acids and you can increase the or decrease the number of oxygen atom. Okay. Now moreover we have one more definition, ortho acid. Ortho acids, from ortho acid we can remove one H2O molecule. Now just see it, if H3PO4 will remove one H2O, we are going to get a new acid HPO3. So from the acid from which we can remove one molecule of H2O, we sometime use word ortho. Phosphoric acid, or more properly orthophosphoric acid. So from the acids from which we can remove one water molecule and resulting molecule is again acid, so we call as such acid as ortho acid. And resulting acid obtained is called as meta acid, and for a meta acid we have to write meta plus name of parent acid. What is parent acid? Phosphoric acid. So we will call it as metaphosphoric acid. So it is very clear that we use prefix ortho with those acids from where we can remove one molecule of water and the resulting molecule is again acid. Such acid is referred as meta acid. And for naming meta acid, we have to use meta along with the name of parent acid. For example, parent acid in this case is phosphoric acid. Okay. Now, again we can have dimerization process. Let's say 2 times H3PO4. And we are removing one H2O molecule, so we are going to obtain pyroacids. We are going to obtain pyroacids. Now we are here, we will get H4P2O7 and we call it as pyro plus name of parent acid. And parent acid is again phosphoric acid, so we call this as pyrophosphoric acid. So this is the whole format. We use ortho acids with those acids from which we can remove one molecule of water and resulting substance is again acid. And for naming ortho acid we use prefix ortho, and resulting acid is referred as meta acid, and for naming meta acid we use meta plus name of parent acid. Now if acid undergoes dimerization process, then removing one H2O molecule, resulting acid is referred as pyro acid. And for naming pyro acid, we use word prefix pyro along with name of the parent acid from where it is derived. Okay. So H3PO4, removing one H2O molecule, it is referred as metaphosphoric acid. And from 2 times, that is dimerization process, we are removing and we are getting pyrophosphoric acid. Now I will give you the list of the reference acid and you can generate more number of acids by increasing and decreasing oxygen and by dimerization you can generate one more set of acid. Okay students, now this is a P block, boron, carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, and in last we have xenon. Now these forms acid. Boron forms acid. Reference acid of boron is H3BO3. We call it as boric acid. And rest element forms similar acids. Now we have carbon. Carbon forms acid.
H2CO3 called as carbonic acid. Nitrogen form acid HNO3 called as nitric acid. Phosphorus forms acid H3PO4 called as phosphoric acid. Sulfur forms acid H2SO4 called as sulfuric acid. And chlorine forms acid HClO3 called as chloric acid. Xenon forms acid H4HCO6 is referred as xenic acid. And rest is group similarity. Be careful, student. Rest it is similar. Like boron, we have aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. It is similar. In case of carbon, we have silicon, germanium, tin and lead. In case of phosphorus, we have arsenic, antimony and bismuth. In case of sulfur, we have selenium, tellurium. Polonium is radioactive, so we don't discuss it. Now in chlorine, we have bromine, iodine and acetidine. Acetidine is again radioactive. So we have, these are the reference acid. Reference acid of boron is boric acid. Reference acid of carbon is carbonic acid. Reference acid of nitrogen is nitric acid. Reference acid of phosphorus is phosphoric acid. Reference acid of sulfur is sulfuric acid. And reference acid of chlorine is chloric acid. Reference acid of xenon is xenic acid. Now, as per group similarity, we have acid of boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. Now we have aluminic acid. What is aluminic acid? H3ClO3. What is gallic acid? H3GO3. Similarly, it is what we have germanic acid? H2GO3. What Latin name of tin is stannum. So what is stannic acid? H2SNO3. What is plumbic acid? H2PbO3. Same format will be there. Now rest of this acid, for nitric acid is slightly different, but rest acid are similar. Like phosphoric acid, we have arsenic acid. Arsenic acid is H3AsO4. Stearic acid is H3SbO4 and bismuthic acid is H3BiO4. Now in case of sulfur, just go for group similarity. Sulfur is sulfuric acid H2SO4. Now selenic acid H2SeO4. Now telluric acid is H2TO4. Finally, we have chloric acid. Now same format. What is bromic acid? HBrO3, HiO3 is iodic acid. Okay, students. Now you can just now increase and decrease the number of oxygen atom for obtaining rest of the acids, and that, and you can further generate pyro and meta acids. Okay, let's just say HNO3 is reference, so we are calling it as nitric acid. Okay, HNO2 we call this as nitrous acid. One oxygen less, one oxygen further less, HNO, we call it as hyponitrous acid. And one oxygen more, we will call it as pernitric acid. Now you can go for some other acids, like H2CO3 is carbonic acid. So H2CO2 is carbonous acid. H2CO is hypocarbonous acid. H2CO4 is percarbonic acid. So you can use this format for other acids by increasing or decreasing. This was the reference
These are other acid, this was a reference, these are the other acids. And you can similarly use other, for example, one more example like H2SO4, it is sulfuric acid. Now just decrease one oxygen, H2SO3 will called as sulfurous acid. Next we have H2SO2, it is called as hyposulfurous acid. H2SO5 is also referred as persulfuric acid. This is sulfuric acid. H2SO6 is referred as hypersulfuric acid. So, 2 above and 2 below, then reference. You can go for other acids using the group similarities. You can have selenic acid, telluric acid. Using group similarities, we can have HIO3 is reference acid like HCl3. We'll call as iodic acid. Now decreasing one oxygen, HIO2 will refer as iodous acid. HIO will refer as hypoiodous acid. HIO4 we per iodic acid. HIO5 we referred as hyper iodic. 2 above and 2 below, you just see it. So we have so many acids. Just by using group similarity. Now one more thing. H2SO4 dimerization process, we are going to get removing H2O, H2S2O7. So this is pyroacid of the sulfur, this is sulfuric acid, sulfuric acid. So we will call this as pyrosulfuric acid. So this is pyrosulfuric acid. You can generate other also. Now similarly just see it, H3BO3, removing one H2 we can obtain one more acid, HBO2. This is referred as boric acid. So we'll call this as meta plus name of parent acid, metaboric acid. And we can, since we can remove one H2O molecule, we can also refer it as orthoboric acid. So this is metaboric acid.